Tommy.
Thomas Angelo.
Detective Narman.
You alone?
No self-respecting badge is coming in here unless it's the health inspector.
What can I get you?
Just a coffee. Thanks. Dip your beak.
No, thanks.
Suit yourself. So, you said on the phone you might have a proposition for me.
That's right.
Well, if you're looking to set up a gravy train, you called the wrong cop. I'm not looking for any associates.
Good. Because I'm on the nut. Can't even pay for the coffee. But I got plenty to trade.
Let's hear it.
How long you been in town?
3 years. Caught my teeth in Empire Bay.
Well, they handed you the Morello case. Right out of the gate.
That's what the paper says, ain't it? And what's it to you?
Tough break. Case must be getting pretty cold by now.
Well, you got something might warm it up.
Yeah. I might have something.
And what's my end of the deal? You want money? Some sort of immunity?
None of that. I got people I need to protect.
Ah, families. Always the Achilles heel, ain't it? So who you got? A sick ma or a wife and a litter of kids?
Wife and daughter.
And no one else to watch your back, I'm guessing.
Wouldn't be here otherwise.
Pity that. Pa always said a man needs friends if he's going to survive in this world.
Yeah. Well, in my world, it's the other way around.
No surprise there. Look, I can't promise anything for your family, not until I hear what you're trading. So, are you talking, or are you just killing time before they come for you?
You think I'm on the run?
Oh, I know it, Tommy. Jesus, look at you. Surely gassed. You haven't slept for days. Your neck's got to be aching from all that looking over your shoulder you're doing. No, the way I figure it is you got someone powerful mean on your tail and they ain't giving up until you end up in the river. And you walk out that door without me, we both know you're not making it 5 steps. But, yeah, you stick around, you tell me your story, and maybe you got a shot at living long enough to walk that girl of yours down the aisle. Either way, looks like I'm buying you a cup of coffee.
Christ, I don't know how everything got so balled up.
No one ever sees the hairpin until it's too late. But you didn't get handed a heater in the nursery, did you?
No. I was a cab driver back in 30.
I mostly drove nights, because the money was better. It was at the end of one of those shifts, when I first met Polly and Sam. Shit!
Trouble. Drive.
How the hell they know we'd be there?
It doesn't matter now. We just gotta lose them.
How many cars we got following?
One for now. But there'll be more.
Gotcha now!
are those guys?
You don't get to ask questions. We need to get over the river. Take the Giuliani Bridge.
Oh, okay.
Your leg okay up there?
Hurts like hell.
When we're back, I'll wake up the doc.
I don't know. It might be okay.
He's getting the call anyways. Hey, I see you listening, cabbie. You don't get to listen either.
All I'm doing is taking you guys where you want to go.
So do that.
You got a death wish or something? Or something?
Okay, we're at the river. Where am I taking you once we're over the bridge?
I'm getting tired out of questions.
Some shortcuts that'll slow him down.
I don't care how you do it. Just shake him off. That was your shortcut?
I lost him, didn't I?
Not all of them.
These guys really don't like it, do they?
Sometimes business partners fall out. It happens. Quit yapping, Polly. The more he knows, the more chance of him not seeing the sun come up.
I ain't heard a thing, fellas.
Real pissed. You left them in the dirt.
We ain't clear yet. Keep driving.
More bastards digging the road for the works program aren't gonna thank us for this. Three crates down. How many motors were at the exchange?
Four?
Five, maybe?
No, with him, he's called for more.
Sure feels like it.
Next time we take one.
You're one hell of a wheel, man, I'll give you that. They must have sent word out. There's more and more of them. We're not gonna last long unless we're back on our own turf. Let's get back to the neighborhood.
West Harbor Bridge, cabbie, fast!
The bridge is up, ain't it?
Yeah, we can make it.
What the hell are we doing?
Just sit tight and pray.
Thank you. never done that before.
Me neither.
Okay, so Little Italy. Now. Your night's not over.
I didn't see this coming. You think he squealed?
I think you zip it tight. We talk it through back at the bar. Okay, we're close.
A little over in front of that bar.
Salieri's place.
Yeah, that's the one. Wait here.
What for?
You want a little something from the Don or not?
Compensation for your services. Any damage to your car. This makes us square.
I'm sure it's more than enough.
Good. Don Salieri wants you to know that he's very grateful. So if you ever need anything, maybe a loan or some honest work, don't hesitate to ask. Don doesn't forget his friends.
Yeah, okay, thanks.
One more thing. This matter stays between us. Anyone asks where you got that money, you want it at poker. The scratches on your car, you swerved to keep from hitting a little old lady. You got it?
Of course.
See you around, kid.
Envelope. I could have had a heart attack. Enough to fix the cap. Nearly enough to buy a new one. I thought about what Sam said about work. I wasn't interested. The money was good, sure, but I didn't want to get in with criminals. Better to be poor and alive than rich and dead. So, right there, back then, I was out. After that night with Salieri's guys, I was back working as soon as I could. But it felt different. You get a lot of time with your thoughts when you're a cabbie. And other people's thoughts, too.
You there, driver?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you driving or loitering?
Driving, ma'am. Always driving. So, where to?
St. Michael's Church, directly. Careful, please.
I always drive careful.
Then you'd be the first. Turn that racket off. I can't hear myself think. That's much better.
So, church. It's Sunday already?
Eyes on the road, please. There, by the park.
Here you go. St. Michael's. That'll be 30 cents.
The only tip I'll give you is to stop smoking in your vehicle. I felt like I was sitting in an ashtray.
Sure. Whatever you say. Can't drive without the radio. Better find a new fare. Gallery. Give me there quick.
Sure. Quick I can do.
What's up?
Taking some time out.
What's it to you?
Not much. Just talking.
I'm paying you to drive, so do that.
Look at him out there.
The problem with this downturn is that it's made people lazy. Giving them an excuse.
The work's not out there, pal.
The work is always there. You just have to find it.
I get it. You're a busy guy. I don't see so many these days.
I saw this crapshoot depression coming. Sold up before the crash. So yeah, I get to be busy.
Your busy day's gonna be looking at old paintings?
I have a business meeting there with a colleague. Not that it's anything to do with you. If you ever find a real job, then maybe you'll understand. Until then, drive and quit bothering me.
Yeah, I get you.
Pull up in front of the gallery. Thanks, pal. Here's 50 cents. I won't spend it all at once.
I'll try not to. Every fair today's been a son of a bitch. On to the next.
Shit.
I've been working since 5. What's your excuse?
Booze.
Figures. Where are we going?
Little Italy, 21st Street.
Okay. If I don't tell the cops about the liquor on your breath, you don't tell them when I break the limit. Good deal.
Great deal. Got any good fares today?
Yeah, some. But never enough of them.
Who's got the money for cab rides since the market tanked and it all went to shit, I guess. Only reason I got you taking me places is I'm drunk. Jesus, that one hurt. Only reason I got you taking me places is I'm drunk and don't know better.
Cops see enough drunk fellas.
They're only after the people moving it and selling it.
Yeah, but I've seen them go after guys for less.
Yeah, so if they think they can shake something out of you, they will use any excuse. This city's corrupt as all hell.
Sure is.
Nearly there. Just up here on the corner, please. Hey, my cousin has a coffee stand around the corner. Tell him Lucio sent you. Take a break, huh?
Thanks. Might just do that.
Hey, how you doing, pal? You remember me? Yeah? Huh? Mr. Morello's a little bent. Shouldn't go helping Salieri's goons, huh? I'm gonna have to give you a beating. Just so you always remember who runs this town. Make it so you won't do much rocking for a while, eh? Look at this guy. I didn't think he'd make it fun. Let's get him.
This.
How you doing, kid? Dino, Lou. You got business with the Don?
Nah, we're just trying to talk to that cabbie over there, that's all.
That right?
Yeah.
Well, this here's the Don's favorite driver. So anything you gotta say to him, you can say to me.
Is that right? Well, I'll tell you something, pal, we ain't leaving empty-handed, that's for sure.
Well, then maybe you ain't leaving at all.
Okay, then. See your boys around. Let's go, Lou.
Thanks.
Least we could do.
Come on, let's go say hi to the Don.
Don Salieri?
Yeah, he's gonna want to hear about this.
What do they call you, son?
Thomas. Thomas Angelo, sir.
Frank told me you ran into some trouble?
Yes, sir. My cab got smashed up pretty good.
Morello's thugs went after him. Are the kind of Tommy helping us?
This, taxi. That's your livelihood?
Yes, sir.
I feel a sense of responsibility here. So I'm gonna set you up with a small loan, enough to get that cab of yours fixed up.
I appreciate that, sir, but I'm not looking for a handout.
Then what are we doing here?
I just want a shot at the bastards who wrecked my cab.
You hear that, Frank? The kid wants my permission to get into a fight.
Yes, I heard.
Okay, Tommy Angelo. All the Morello's grills hang out at a bar he owns. Paul, you know the place.
Sure do, boss.
Good. You can ride along with Tommy. There's a lot right next to the bar where they park their cars. Go smash up a few tin cans, send Morello a message. He can't rough up hard-working Joes in my neighborhood without getting a black eye.
Thank you, Mr. Salieri. I won't let you down.
And Tommy, when you get back, we'll talk about what's next for you.
No one else knows you here, so tread careful, okay?
Sure.
The boss finished yet?
Nah, you got more time to sit on your ass.
Who's the new guy?
Find anything good?
Nah,
I'm watching.
He's gonna drive the boss?
Got it?
Nah,
I get it.
You don't lose your job that easy.
I hate sitting around. Born as hell. I don't get what the problem is. What do you think I gotta do to purchasing and lending policies? Does he stay, Ricordi?
Ah, si. Si. Come back later. With Osen. The bars are closed. For you, I'm afraid.
Anyways, I got places to be. Okay, come through this way. I'll take you to Vinny first. He's a loudmouth, but Frank and Adon have known him since forever.
What's he do?
We go see him whenever we need to do any, heavy lifting. He makes sure we're well healed for when there's trouble.
We're grateful for his dough, but we gotta go. Long drive back.
Buongiorno, Vincenzo!
Ciao, Polly! Oh, she's gonna sing! Who's this then?
Vinny, this here's Tommy Angelo. We're doing a little job together.
All right, good, good.
Hey,
you just need bean shooters or rods?
Nah, we just need something to write off a few cars.
Huh. Oh, I got just the thing. This classic should do the trick! If the bat don't work out for you, I got a few cocktails here.
Ay, ay, ay.
Careful with them, though. Don't want to burn off your short ears.
Good to meet you, Tom. Let me know if Paulie gives you the hard time. I'll straighten him out. Come back and see me later if the boys don't scare you away. I'll fix you with a gat.
Ralphie's in the garage. He's a special kind of idiot, but he's got a way with cars. I don't get how this moron gets interested in her. But I'm telling you, it's like some kind of black magic. Hey, genius! Get your head out of your ass!
What the fuck, dear Polly? You can't just sneak up on a guy like that.
I'm sorry, Ralphie. I'm just busting your balls.
See, you're still a little limping. Guess we got two cripples working here.
We ain't nothing alike. You got that, Ralph?
Sure, Papa Polly. Yeah.
Tommy Angelo.
Good to meet you.
Like I said, Ralphie here's a cracked egg. But you bring him a stolen car, he'll make it yours. Tom and me, we got a job to do. We need some wheels.
How about this one, Papa Polly? It ain't a hot rod, but it'll get you across the town.
All right, let's go. You're driving. And don't let me catch you loafing off again.
One day I'm gonna cut your brake line, asshole.
I don't know what Ralph's trying to pull giving us this motor. I want to show you something about the good life, and you're driving something my mom could have bought 20 years ago. If I know Ralph, he probably got it taken out of our yard.
Yeah, the car's fine. It's good to get a change from the cab.
You don't have to be nice about it. This thing's a tin can.
So, was that whiskey back there in the truck?
Yep, new supplier.
You guys deal in broad daylight?
Normally, nah. This was their first drop-off. And the cops know better than to come sniffing around our turf. Morello, the guy whose cars you gonna torch, he's got more friends on the force than us. We're okay, as long as we're careful. Keep an eye over our shoulder. Some of the Canadian whiskey that comes through, if you want a bottle, just ask. We'll keep some back for friends.
I'm no big drinker. I used to tip back bathtub gin most days, but not so much now. That stuff's no good for you.
You don't have to go blind now, though. To us, you got a line in the good stuff.
Well, that's good of you. Thanks.
Not just the booze we supply, Tom. It's the places we deliver to. The dames they got in these places. Best tables, best food, best skirt. Some way to live.
Right now, all I want to do is wreck the day of the bastards who wrecked mine.
Sure.
Besides, all this could get a guy in trouble.
Trouble says the guy is about to set fire to Morello's parking lot.
I got you to protect me. It'll go fine.
Well, if it don't go fine, try not to let him see your face. Either that, or you hit him so hard they don't remember it. Getting onto Morello's turf now.
There's some kind of line between his streets and Celieri's streets?
Not really. There's always some give and some take. Though in general, we look after Little Italy, and his guys work North Park. And more besides. You're walking on the wrong sidewalk, in a wrong part of town, you start getting a sense you need to be someplace else. You can feel it long before they start appearing on street corners to stare you down. Okay, it's close by. Morello's goons smoke and jaw up front and leave their motors out back. They're some lazy bastards. Put some gorilla on guard duty, but it's always some no-name schmuck. Come on, over here. You gotta sneak in and wreck the cars. Send a message.
Sure. Why are you coming with?
To see if you get shot. Okay, you go quiet. You know how to go quiet, right? Yeah, like that.
Got his main guys. You'll get there soon. one sees our heads. No one tries to pop them. Over this gate and up onto their roof. I'll go keep their chump busy while you creep up and jump them from behind. I'm real good at distracting. It's my best thing.
He's good for it.
Hey! What the hell you doing?
What do you mean, what am I doing?
I mean what I say. What the hell are you doing back there?
Who are you?
A guy who don't know what idiot told you to keep lookout here.
Dino. Dino told me.
Dino? Salieri's got guys all over town trying just like that. I got it. Now let's get to these cars. Take your bat and start swinging. Use the bat, Tom. Ah, that's great. No one's driving that again. Ah, crap. Hey, get away from the car. Knock him down, Tom.
Shouldn't be.
You got some kind of death wish? Hmm? Just like that.
Son of a...
Of them. Use a Molotov and let's see some flames. Love your work. Love the smell of burning paintwork.
Whole block heard that.
We gotta go. We can take Dino's car.
How'd you know this is Dino's car?
I don't like you, and you got a good car? I'm gonna know where you...
Reports of burning vehicles and gunfire in North Park. It's right near Morello's place. Don't bring in the wrong people.
Old ways are the best ways. Straight through the gate! We gotta get out of here before the bull show!
There's don't let him get away!
Drive!
Come back, you bastards!
Officers have seen him. Now in pursuit.
Ah, shit. We got cops.
So, what do we do?
We lose them by driving real fast and getting clear of them.
Sounds good.
Right now they're pissed. But let's not get them real pissed. Okay, we lost them. Stay out of sight till they lose interest. Drive careful, Tom. We don't need more heat.
Get him next time.
We're good. Let's head back and see the boss.
I thought Salieri had cops on the books.
Some street cops, sure. But Morello's got the chief in his pocket. How'd it feel? Feel good?
How'd what feel?
Taking out the guy. Hank and Dino's car. Feel good?
Yeah, I guess it did.
There's no time like the first time, Tom. Don't get better. You think it's for you? This life?
What's it to you?
Hey, I'm just asking questions. I like asking questions.
I doubt that every day you and Sam go and panel beat motors in parking lots.
Eh. There's busy days, there's slow days. I've had more of an introduction than I ever got.
You never got to beat up Dino's pals and take his motor?
Nah, stole enough cars to get noticed, I guess. When I got squeezed by the cops, knew never to squeal. And one day I found myself in a yard behind a bar drawn with Vincenzo. 10 years go by and I'm still there. So, I got a suit now, and Vinny's an old bastard.
I always thought that to be in a family you had to have more connections. Your brother, or your uncle, or...
Oh, some guys, sure. Your cousin got made, or you like Carlos, Pop went way back with the Don. That means you get trusted more when you're starting out. There's plenty of us who came in off the street. I'm thinking we get you in front of the boss, then we tip a few.
Well, I don't got plans, so...
Sure you don't got plans. The plans are to feed Vinny so much booze that Luigi has to roll him out the door again.
I'm good with whatever.
Sure you are.
What happened to the car I sent you out with?
Dumped it.
Well, why?
It was a boiler. This one's better.
A better car with a broken window?
Pressure ain't never killed nobody.
He's still with you, then?
Somehow, yeah.
Hey, boss. It's done.
No trouble?
Nothing we couldn't handle, Mr. Salieri.
Good, good. Sit down. You see Morello?
Nah. But he'll be plenty pissed when his boys tell him what happened.
He's not gonna be able to think straight for weeks. See, that's the difference between me and Morello. I'm a businessman. I do everything with this. Every decision I make, it's what's good for the business and my boys. But Morella is a hothead, and all that anger burns out the brain. And when he gets mad, he gets stupid.
You got nothing like that to worry about with Tommy here. He was aces the whole way, boss.
I'm glad to hear it. I got a growing business here. We could use a guy like you to help out around the bar. Maybe run some errands, make sure the bills get paid on time. You up for that?
Oh, it'd be an honor, sir.
Good. Good. Now, Polly and Sam have already vouched for you, but you need to understand we have a few rules around here, so you listen and listen good. First, no cursing on the premises. There's a million words out there. And the man who needs to resort to fuck this and fuck that is just ignorant or lazy. Second, we don't deal in the hard stuff. I don't want any dope fiends in this neighborhood. We'll let Morella poison his own people if that's what he wants. Finally, stay out of trouble with the cops. We only have a few on the payroll. And if you cross the line, the rest will come after you. You understand?
Yes, Mr. Salieri.
Then I'm going to only ask you for one more thing, Tommy. I don't keep Paulie and Sam around just because they're strong. A lot of guys out there bigger and tougher than these two. And I don't keep Frank on the payroll because he's smart. Though he is an artist with the numbers. All these guys in this room, they're here because they have the only thing that matters to me. The only thing that should matter to any of us. You know what that is, Tommy?
They're loyal.
That's right. Now, you stay straight with me, you're gonna be living the high life, Tom. But you abuse my trust.
Don Salieri, you won't ever need to worry about me.
Okay, then. Welcome to the family. Excellent. Now I'm starving. Luigi, let's eat.
Welcome. A barman Luigi is not much of a cook. But his daughter, Sarah, Maron.